So what are some of the critical factors when companies are considering outsourcing?
Well, first of all, the company should know, are they ready to outsource completely? Should they try an insource or some sort of hybrid outsourcing model? And if the process maturity that we talked on a different talk is there, if that is the case and they are ready to outsource, then roughly we break it into five buckets. And we call it the five C's of outsourcing, a term that we came up with. The very first one is C for cost. So one of the biggest considerations to outsource is, will it cost me more or less or equal than what I'm spending in-house? Typically, if it's an outsourcing model where you're using local vendors and not going offshore, your cost will be probably equal or a little bit higher because your chosen outsourcer has a margin built in to what they're operating at when their costs are about similar to what you have in-house. So, but if cost is really a factor and the driving force behind the outsourcing process is a reduction in cost, then obviously you have to look at cost-effective models such as offshoring or automation, which we also consider as an essential element as part of the outsourcing process. The second one would be capacity. So, are you challenged by capacity challenges right now? Do you have a huge project coming up, or do you see a change in industry cycles? Do you see a growth in your business where you're going to need a lot more people and a lot more resources coming up? So to counter that capacity challenge, then you have to decide whether you want to hire them as employees, as contractors. Are you going to do an outsourcing model? What we recommend to our customers is to do all of them and keep a certain amount of outsourcing capability so that the external vendor can also grow the business along with the actual client. And so capacity considerations are important to map out and decide how much of resources do I need over what time period and how to make that happen. The third one would be capability. So is the capability that I'm trying to outsource, is that available, first of all? Is that something so unique that is an IP for my company that I want to keep in-house or I'm unable to share with external partners? In that case, of course, outsourcing will not work. But if that capability is something that A, exists externally, is common in the industry or expected to be known by your vendor partners, then that makes a good model for outsourcing. Or if it's something that can be trained, it might have some internal things that the company has done that can be trained to the external vendor, then it can be outsourced. So the capability is definitely one of those factors. The fourth one is C for criticality. So how critical are these processes? So it used to be that when outsourcing, companies would consider sending out the least critical processes, such as transaction-oriented processes, and anything that needed analytical skill sets were kept in-house. But that has, with the maturity of the industry, for example, in mortgage banking, where we operate, it used to be very simple tasks like data entry and getting online searches done. But now with the maturity of the industry of the 20 plus years that we've been doing this work, now all of the workers across the outsourcing spectrum have gone up that knowledge cycle where more critical tasks, tasks that are somewhat subjective, not so objective, what is called core to the industry. There's a term core versus non-core. So that line has somewhat grayed on what is core and what is non-core. So essentially, if that knowledge exists externally, if the vendor is able to perform at the very high levels required by your contract, then criticality is increasingly something that is subjective to be determined based on your vendor partner. And the final one is compliance. And this is a big one because we work and operate in the financial and banking industries where compliance is at the central core of everything that is done. So compliance across many areas, compliance in terms of the regulations that we have to know and perform under. We have various regulators in the industry, CFPB, we have our GAC regulators, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, et cetera. We have banking regulators. So all these regulations, is the vendor that you choose, or are they will be able to comply to all of these exacting requirements? There are also IT compliance issues in terms of data security. We are talking of private confidential data from our borrowers, etc. Will these be complied to by the vendor? And do they have the infrastructure and the people and the process and the compliance paraphernalia and the people in place to keep to this high standard? So roughly within those five parameters, if you can look deeply and say there's a fit, then and only then an outsourcing project should be taken to fruition. And if any of those areas are found to be lacking, then first that has to be fixed, or an appropriate partner found that has already solved for that, or it needs to be a joint process between the vendor and the client to sort out those challenges before you outsource.
So let's expand on the topic of capability, one of these five C's that you mentioned. What does that encompass when it comes to operations, licenses, facility security, training, those types of features?
Correct. So the chosen partner, outsourcing partner, needs to be have all of the capabilities that you would expect doing that work in-house. So you mentioned a few. For example, do they have enough space to put all the people? And if there's a requirement for growth, do they have the ability to grow quickly rather than having to, you know, go out and look for new floor space? So do they have, are they operating at full capacity and will not have the ability to grow quickly, or will they? So that's the space aspect. On the licensing aspect, yes, all of the licenses that are required by the industry. We're in a highly compliant industry of mortgage banking and banking in general. So do they have all of these licenses required to operate, such as the BSA, the AML, the SOC, and other security certificates? It could be either in the operation side or on the IT side of things. And have they been certified by third-party vendors and third-party regulators that both parties can trust? In terms of the security, yes, we do need secure facilities. There are many multi-layered levels of security needed in an industry, starting with physical security, followed by security of scanning the folks that are working on these projects to make sure that they have right background checks done, etc. Physical security could also entail digital devices and bringing that into the facility. There could be also data security and IT security issues in terms of highly sensitive data that we're dealing with, that it does not go out of the network, it is not hacked, there is no issues with loss of data, loss of information either through means of computer networks or an errant employee taking that data outside and using it for profit. So all of these are considerations, and the outsourcing vendor has to be set up with all of these standards to mirror and match, possibly at a higher level than what even the client has in-house.
Thank you so much, Souren. We really appreciate your time and giving us all your valuable insight in the industry. And we recognize why you're now the mortgage technology guru. Stay tuned.